I am Maria Aparicio. I'm one of the owners of Kakawa Coffee.
My name is Gladys Mubayed. I'm one of the owners of Kakawa.
Kakawa is the first registered word for chocolate in the Olmec language. And when the Mayans started working the chocolate, they adopted that word. It was all a coincidence because, you know, I'm from Mexico and where I'm from, it's Maya. And when we hit that name, it was like, we're keeping this name.
The foundation is like, we're family. We understand the customers.
I think that's the spirit of what we were looking for in our coffee shop, not just a place where we can go and get a drink, but a place where everyone knew our name. It was our community. We know a lot of the people who come here are the other patrons.
Every time I see people come in, yeah, they know all of their customers because people feel comfortable here. They feel special, like I do.
It's very much our Cheers bar, but for coffee in our mornings.
We want to be like known as a community. That's why we chose a small business inside the community that's not a mall. Maria started a book club. She loves reading because that really makes her happy and she's so much into it. I mean, honestly, she put a good amount of energy. These folks, they don't want to come, they don't want to go anywhere because they're also older people. That doing this, they stay in touch. It's physical distance, but not really social. We still engage with them. They do the Zoom. They're so happy. They're so grateful for that. But before that, we used to do an open mic.
I would come down and bring some of my students as well and play. It's kind of a great little intimate vibe that we can get going in this little spot.
The young generation, they're intimidated like to go behind the mic and sing.
It's not like you're going stepping up on a stage. There's a lot less pressure, and everybody's very friendly. And there's only going to be a few people that are going to be, you know, looking at you.
And it's kind of like fun. This is how you meet people. This is how you encourage people. And it brings a different touch to our coffee shop.
Because we are a new business, this is our second year, and we had customers, and we started building that reputation. The clientele, the customers, and all that changed in March. So we stopped seeing our customers, the traffic started slowing down.
But it was also very stressful because I don't want to expose her or expose me to something that, God forbid, something happened, and we're not going to take this home. I have my mom with me, she has her kids. It was really, really stressful. Like, you had no idea. Like, we had, you know, to change the setup. The cleaning, always, we're very, very picky about the cleaning, but there was like a tons of time more now.
We have to be creative like most business owners, and it's like we need to push the coffee in our coffee bags.
So I get this big bag, it says 12 ounces, it's not. I said, no, you have to give me more than the 12 ounces, otherwise you have to do four little bags. So they started getting this big bag for me, and this makes it a little easier.
We kept, you know, talking to our customers that, you know, now you gotta go and order our coffee online so you can still drink our coffee, and that worked well. But it's definitely had an impact on the way we run our coffee shop, because by definition, a coffee shop, you come and drink coffee and you sit and socialize, and that's pretty much gone for right now.
But again, we're here. We're honestly trying our best to pour quality, good customer service, because we want the customer leaving happy.
And that's why I keep coming back.
Favorite coffee drink?
The Mayan mocha. That's my all-time favorite because it's spicy. The sweet chocolate, the dark chocolate, the chai and the paprika, and then the regular espresso and the milk. I like it extra spicy, so when I make my drink, I put more.
My go-to is typically the Mayan mocha, extra spicy. Oh, it's so good. It's so good. If you haven't had it and you like spice, you should grab it. It's really tasty. And I'm actually drinking it iced right now, which is really nice. You got a little bit of the heat with the ice.
So now we're gonna try the Arabian mocha. It's dark chocolate sauce and a cardamom spice. My parents are Syrian. I grew up eating cardamom in my food. and drinking it in my tea. I used to steal my mom the Turkish coffee once in a while, or soak my cookie in it whenever she's not looking. So definitely, that's how I was introduced to the cardamom. We use a dark chocolate for the Arabian mocha.
Ah, yes, chocolate.
It balances very well.
This definitely tastes like it smells.
I was gonna say that.
Because the cardamom of the Middle East is very aromatic. It really travels above and beyond in time and date, all like. So we want it to be an experience. Right now we're trying our signature latte, which is cacao latte. So tell me, what do you think about this? And I want to see what's the taste of it.
Sorry, I was just so intrigued.
Yeah.
Okay, this is my favorite. This is definitely my favorite.
There is like a bunch of layers to the flavor that I really appreciate. I can accidentally drink like 4 or 5 cups.
Exactly. I can get like an extra large one and just drink it out. Just drink it throughout the day.
Yeah, say that on our social media because I want to see the line down the street. I really want them to love our product and appreciate the product.
Because we want to deliver, we want to give the freshest espresso.
It's not just another coffee. I can guarantee that.